All right, what's going on, guys? Welcome to episode 2 of Run It Back. Today, I'm going to be going over my Chiefs vs. Broncos edit from week 15 of the 2019 NFL season. I got a lot of feedback of people wanting to see the timeline as I go through my project, so I'm going to try to have it up on the screen as I scrub through so that way you can follow along. All right, let's get started. I'm going to show you the entire edit once, and then I'll go back and break it down section by section.
I'm icy. I'm clean. I'm icy. Like I'm eyeless, I'm Billy. That boy loud, flow so cold, loco, crazy, silly. You ever gon' stop rap thinking, no, no, not really. I'm icy.
I'm icy. I'm clean.
I'm clean.
So when putting together an edit, I usually find my song first. A lot of people ask if I lay down my footage first and then find a song, or if I find a song first and then lay my footage on top. I'm an editor that finds a song first, breaks it down into under a minute, and then use that to kind of build my template of putting footage on top. Just the way the song kind of broke down, I didn't really have a lot of time in this first section to kind of show the players arriving, so I kind of got onto field pretty quick, unlike my last video where I got to show a couple more shots and build it up a little more. So I made sure to in and out the parts where you could see the breath leaving the players as we're walking through. This is not CGI, this is actually how cold it was in the building walking inside. In episode 1, I talked about matching action to get myself outside here. I didn't really have much action to work with, but I decided to use shots of players walking to their left as the matching action right here. As you see, Patrick walking right to left, and then Tyreek, he's walking in that same direction, but now with full pads getting ready for warmups, and then brings you outside. So even if it's not an obvious choice to match the action, I'll still try to find something similar in the shots leading me through my progression to get somewhere. And then as you can see right here, the music dies almost down to zero.
I'm icy.
To me, whenever music kind of dies down and there's a little lull of silence, I like to have a very specific action in that lull to kind of break up that silence and it doesn't get awkward. So with this little pause, if you can see, I made sure to put Pat's eyes move right there.
Clean. I'm icy.
I'm icy.
I'm icy.
Does it make the edit any better? No idea, but it's just something I think about. Into the drop.
I'm icy.
I'm icy. I'm clean.
I'm clean.
So when editing to the music, I tried to make my cuts as close to on beat as possible, but I think sometimes it can get a little repetitive if you're on the beat every single time with every cut. So what I do to break that up is to, instead of cutting on beat, is to speed ramp on beat, or speed ramp when he starts singing or when you hear a certain instrument. That kind of helps break it up and kind of gives you almost a little more freedom than just to not always have to be stuck to cutting on the huge beats. You can speed ramp to the small beats, cut on the small beats, cut on a hi-hat, cut on a snare. Just kind of taking your time to listen to the music a little more carefully to hear all the intricate parts will really help you edit your footage to those parts to make it seem like the music was made for this edit instead of you editing to the music. I didn't really want to do a lot of overlays on this edit because of the snow, a lot of snow falling, and I thought that was a cool visual, so I kind of made that my overlay, if you will. Usually I'll have those specks, dust and flares and all this stuff, but I thought it was cool to just have the snow right here be the overlay. And also, I don't think every edit needs an overlay. If your shots are good, show them off. So if you put effects and overlays on top, people aren't going to be able to see how good your shots are. Keep it simple. All I did was that box overlay just to kind of give it my own little thing. But other than that, pretty simple timeline. All right, so let's jump back into the main part of the video.
I'm icy, I'm icy, I'm so cold, I'm chilly. You
know I got the C-notes like I'm eyeless, I'm Billy. That boy loud, you flow so cold, low, go crazy.
So one thing I like to do is I like to use speed ramping to kind of emphasize juke moves. It kind of brings your footage alive a little bit. All right, so then I get into the first touchdown of the game as a deep pass to Tyreek Hill. It's actually one of my favorite shots of the season, this part right here. I'm gonna show you the raw clip just so y'all get a glimpse of what I'm seeing behind the camera. Here it is in full. Ideally, I could see what Pat's doing, but he's being blocked by these linemen and defenders. So it's really hard to tell where the ball's going. I don't even know how I saw the ball leave his hands. Like, that ball looks like a person's head. But saw something left and I was like, oh, this is going deep. And once he starts shooting football enough, you kind of learn people's tendencies. And like, if the play is going on for a while with Patrick, I know he's going deep. So if I ever have to bail and just, I don't know what's going on, I'm just gonna zoom out and find the closest receiver to me, meaning the deepest receiver to Patrick. So here you can see ball goes out. I kind of zoom out hoping that the ball stays in frame, but it goes way above frame. So I'm like, uh-oh, it's going deep. So then I pan over, try to find somebody, and it's Tyreek Hill running at me. I lock on to him because I know if this is a completion, the ball's gotta go to Tyreek. So I'll just follow Tyreek. And then he kind of gets out of frame. I didn't really get the celebration. So shooting football by yourself, it's really hard to get every single angle, every single play, every single celebration. So if you are shooting football, don't be hard on yourself if you miss something, because likely a lot of other people missed it. Just focus on getting the most out of what you can get from your angle. And then just putting that together in the end for your edit, because you're not going to use every single shot. And then another thing is, whenever I'm shooting football, I make sure to get a couple different angles of the quarterback throwing or handing off the ball. That way, when you're at home later editing, you can kind of stitch together a shot of the step back and then a shot of the touchdown. Because usually when I get the touchdown, I'm in the end zone, and so I don't have a good shot of Patrick. So luckily this game, I did that. This could have been an incompletion. This could have been a handoff. This could have been anything, but using that to supplement this shot really helps, because I did not get a good shot of the throw because Patrick was covered up right here. So that's a good tip for when you're shooting football or anything, is just to have different angles of kind of the process of one action. So that way, if you can fake it and get an angle from this play, match it with an angle from that play, and kind of make it look like you were in two spots at once, that's an easy way to add more angles to edit when you only have one shooter. Then again, that's two separate plays, but I stitched them together to make it look like one play. Patrick stepping back and then Sammy Watkins catching it. Now, when I do this, I make sure that the throw angle and the angle of the catch are similar. As you can see, Patrick's kind of throwing to his right. Seems like a bullet pass down and low. It's not a bomb or anything. When I switch to Sammy catching it, it kind of looks like, oh, that ball could have been from that last shot. That's something you got to keep an eye on if you're going to match action from several different plays. And then that's the end. Another touchdown from Patrick to Tyreek. This time I got Patrick throwing it, so you could see him there, Tyreek catching it there, and then made sure to slow it down for this slide. I thought it was hilarious that he just caught it and kind of slid. And then ended it with a quick shot of Patrick celebrating to the fans. Yeah, that's the entire edit. If you have any comments or additional questions about how I put this video together, please leave a comment below, or you can DM me on my social medias, Billy Quach Films. Hopefully this helps you kind of get a behind the scenes look at how I put my videos together. Other than that, hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode, and I'll see you on the next one. Deuces.
Still going bad on you anyway.
Whoa. I can feel like 80 rats in my Mary's. Me and Drizzy back to back is getting scary. Back to back.